Today we'd like to talk about the finite difference frequency domain method boundary conditions and symmetry conditions. The problem that I want to solve is this problem of a rectangular duct. We've been doing rectangular ducts before. This time I'm going to have a potential of 20 volts on the right, 20 volts on the left, and the top and the bottom are going to have slightly different boundary conditions than I had before. On the top and the bottom, we're going to say that the derivative of the potential with respect to y is 15 volts per meter on the top, meaning that it's changing positively in this direction, and that it's minus 15 volts per meter changing in this direction on the top. This boundary condition is called a Dirichlet boundary condition. That means that the potential is set at some specific value. When we set points like this, we'll simply set those equal to 20 volts per meter, as we mentioned in our last lecture. Same thing on this side. But these boundary conditions need to be handled a little bit differently. So let's talk about how we can solve for those. Those boundary conditions are called Neumann boundary conditions, and they represent the derivative of the potential being set at the boundary. So let's see how we can handle that. Here's a picture of one of the cells at the boundary, this one right here, for instance, where this point is phi of ij, that's right on the boundary, right here's the boundary. Below it is phi ij minus 1, and above it is phi ij plus 1. If we wanted to write the derivative of the potential with respect to y, we'd be simply doing a derivative. So it would be phi ij plus 1 minus phi ij minus 1 divided by the distance right here between the points. This would be my derivative. We've done these numerical derivatives in the past. And in the case where I have this bottom boundary, I would set that equal to 15 volts per meter. Now, how can we do this in practice? We would have divided this model up into a series of cells. Here's an example of the grid that we might have used in this model. Where this is h, that's the cell distance right there. So I have this point, I have my phi ij point, but notice I didn't actually use that in my derivative. I have my phi ij plus 1 point, that's up inside the grid, but I don't have this point right here. So this is actually going to be my boundary condition point. I'm going to add an extra set of points out here where I have my Neumann boundary condition, and this is where I'm going to solve for my boundary. I'm actually going to solve for phi ij minus 1 using my boundary conditions. So phi I of j minus 1 is going to be 15 times 2h in this case. Let's see, I need to put a minus sign there, and minus plus phi I j plus 1. So here's the condition for all of these cells here on the boundary, and they're going to use the internal points up here that I already have. Now what about this boundary on the top? That's essentially the same thing, except it's coming down this way. In that case, the derivative with respect to y is still exactly the same thing. Phi I is equal to phi ij plus 1 minus phi ij minus 1 divided by 2h, but this time I solve for this point, and I'll say that phi I j plus 1 is equal to 2h, this is 15 volts per meter, 2h times my minus 15 plus phi of I j minus 1. The phi I j minus 1 terms are right here inside my boundary. The phi I j terms right here are solved using my standard stencil, and then I need a set of separate points up here at the top that are going to be my boundary conditions. So how do I solve for this in practice? Remember last time we talked about doing the FD-FD method with SOR, and in that case we had an equation for the residual Rij, and we solved, and that was phi of ij plus 1 plus phi of ij minus 1 plus phi of I minus 1j plus phi of I plus 1j minus 4 phi of ij minus b of ij, all divided by 4. And then I would write phi of ij is equal to phi of ij plus omega rij, and I would do that for each step in an SOR calculation. I'm going to do exactly the same thing this time. I'm going to set a set of for loops for I equals, I'm going to calculate all of these values in here. For all of those values, for I equals inside and for j equals inside. In that case, I'm going to say phi ij is equal to phi ij plus omega rij, and end those for loops right there. And then I'm going to set these boundary conditions at 20 volts, these boundary conditions at 20 volts, and these boundary condition points using this equation, and these boundary condition points using this equation. That's going to allow me to solve for this duct that has a combination of Dirichlet and Neumann boundary conditions.